That's right. My guest is Executive Councilor Chris Pappas, a Democrat in Manchester running for re-election.
Nice to be here. Thanks for having me.
You've been in the news lately, or your campaign has been in the news all week. You had some Republicans endorsing your campaign, and then Republicans say, hey, you can't be really a Republican if you're endorsing a Democrat like Chris Pappas.
They say there's no such thing as bad press, and we found that out this week. So they gave our story some legs.
What do you make of the dust up of this whole thing?
Well, you know, I mean, the Republican Party can tell its members to do whatever it wants to do, I guess. But the people of New Hampshire are pretty independent-minded. They're going to make up their own decisions about which candidates to support. And I think people like to pick and choose between the best individuals for particular offices. So the fact that we've got quite a few Republicans supporting me in this campaign, lots of independents and Democrats, I think is indicative of the type of leadership I've offered on the executive council and the type of balance I think we need to maintain on the council the next 2 years.
You are in your first term. Of course, there are five executive councilors. Democrats have a one-seat majority right now, which is very important for the for Democrats to get Governor Maggie Hassan's agenda through. We've had two Republicans trying to take you on. We just had a primary. Bob Burns won. Your opponent from last time. What did you make of those primary results?
You know, I thought it was a little bit interesting because I figured the Republicans were going to go in a different direction. But the voters selected Mr. Burns again, and be happy to have a vigorous campaign against him. I think, you know, 2 years ago, the voters said that they didn't want an extreme agenda at the executive council. They didn't want Tea Party politics brought up at that level. And so we pushed back against that. We were successful. Mm-hmm. That's the type of campaign we're going to run again. But we have the experience of the last 2 years and the things that we've been working on the council to talk about in this campaign as well. So I've been proud of our work on a bipartisan basis on several important issues, including Medicaid expansion, making sure that's implemented and stood up on time. We've got over 15,000 folks in New Hampshire that have now enrolled in that because of the plan that was pushed forward by the legislature and implemented by the council. We've worked on transportation issues, including making sure that Manchester has the opportunity to develop passenger rail, a passenger rail link to Boston, which I think is critical for this region, and making sure government's streamlined and that the process is more efficient. We've done some work on that as well.
Well, great. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks so much.
Now, you can read more about this executive council race and other state races at WMUR.com/political scoop. That does it here for TV. Now back to you. You have a few more minutes here online. What do you think that is the number one issue of this campaign?
I mean, I think it comes down to your philosophy and the direction of the state over the long term. I don't think the executive council is the place where you need someone who's going to be a political lightning rod. I think it's the place, as Ray Burton showed, and councilors of both parties have shown over the years, where you need people who represent their entire districts, are moderate, are balanced, and are going to be pragmatic about the decisions that they make.
You know, one of the interesting thing I thought after the 2012 election is that the executive council got a lot younger. Colin Van Oster, and of course Chris Sununu. Looking back now, what do you think that's meant?
I think it matters in terms of the process, and we've helped modernize the process. We always joke that before this term, the biggest innovation on the executive council was double-sided copies, which they did about 5 or 6 years ago. So we're now doing our business on iPads.
Right.
We've gone all electronic, and we're trying to encourage that upstream so that all the departments, when they're doing the contracting process, that's all made electronic as well. We've raised the thresholds for contracts because state agencies spend 40 to 80 hours on an individual item, and when it's a low-dollar item and it's never controversial, never voted down, it's a question of resources.
And the threshold is now what?
It was raised to $10,000 for personal service contracts, $20,000 for all other contracts. And we just did that at our last meeting.
Yeah. What do you think of this election year? It looks like to be a very big Republican year. We had a bunch of polls out this week on the major races, some all over the place. Gene Shaheen winning by 11, Gene Shaheen, one of them losing by 2 as a Republican poll that came out on that. What do you make of this environment that you have to run in?
I think people are focused on what leaders are doing for them and their communities, and I think this election is going to come down to how people feel about the direction of things in the state of New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. People have great confidence in what leaders are doing in Concord. We've seen some important bipartisan compromises on Medicaid expansion, which I mentioned, the state budget, and that's what people want to see. I've been to every town in my district, met with boards of selectmen and local leaders, and they all say, no matter what their perspective is, they just want things to get done. They want the ball to be moved forward. They want people to be responsive and just to be pragmatic about it.
I expect I'm not going to get an honest answer here, but maybe we'll get one. This is your first time in elected office. A lot of work. Is it, are you enjoying it? Is it more than you expected? What's it been like?
You feel like you're in grad school at some times because of the amount of reading that you're doing.
Particularly on the executive council.
Yeah, but I was first elected to the legislature in 2002, so I've served several terms in state, county, and now on the executive council. So I've had that experience as well. But, you know, there are surprises around every corner. One of the surprises is the amount of constituent work that you're doing. And we're such a great portal for people to get access to state government, get answers, because we have a direct line to all the commissioners. And so if people email me with a problem about a road in their town or about an environmental permit they're getting, I can get the commissioner of that department to contact that constituent directly and take care of the issue. So we're almost like an ombudsman for our district, and we've been very successful at connecting communities and people with their state government.
Great, Chris, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.